All right, so we're trying out a new camera angle, as you can see, and I do not have the car mic'd up in the sense of the exhaust and the engine bay, which some of you might have seen that already. I do have a new mic set up. Hopefully the audio comes through okay. I have a couple microphones up here. I'm trying something a little bit new. We're gonna see how this sounds. So I wanted to record this video and kind of go over the Eurocompulsion Phase 1 Burbles tune, as well as the Ragazone exhaust system, and some talk about the Forge blow valve and wastegate actuator and how I was able to get it to work properly. So I had a lot of questions online from a few folks on, you know, Facebook and Instagram, and I'll have the links in the description if you want to follow me there. People asking me if the Phase 1 tune was worth it and how I felt about it. And honestly, 100% it's worth it. On this car, the mid-range stock has some decent punch to it. Top end kind of dies off a little bit. With the Phase 1 tune, you 100% feel the power. It just throws you back in the seat so much more in that mid-range. Up top, it still gives you extra power, but like the factory, you know, it's still gonna die out a little bit because we're still working with that same small turbo, small engine, and there's only so much you can do to that. So besides the fact that up top is still, you know, it doesn't pull like crazy, and that's not what this car is meant to do. It's meant to be a nice, small, fun, little agile car, and that's exactly what it is. I did want some more power. The Phase 1 tune 100% delivers. You can feel that mid-range punch. You can feel it up top, down low, everywhere, but specifically in the mid-range, I really feel that power pushing you back. The car just, it pulls very smooth as well, which I'm gonna touch base on a little bit later. We're gonna cover the Forge blow valve and wastegate actuator, because those were actually two things that I was having issues with. I had some surge, some stutter. I might have another video that goes a little more in depth that shows you what I was hearing. And then if you guys have a similar issue, you'll know what to do. Basically, just to quickly break it down, Forge switched up their colors with their spring rates. It used to be the yellow spring is what you use for this car. If it's tuned, give or take, you know, you want to get, for example, the wastegate, they recommended the yellow spring at between 9 to 11 wastegate crack pressure. I had that and I was seeing some surge, some stutter. It was kind of up top the throttle, I think, as at Eurocompulsion, I think they were saying it was kind of letting off the throttle almost. You kind of hear the blow valve going off, and it wasn't supposed to, even at full throttle. And we swapped it to the purple spring at that, you know, I think 9.5 to 10 PSI crack pressure. And now I don't have that anymore. When I'm going full out, full throttle to redline, I don't have that breaking up top that was coming from having the yellow spring instead of the purple. Now, you might have the yellow and it might be fine. I don't know when they switched it, but they switched up the springs. So you might have the proper spring already if it's yellow, but if you have a yellow and it's acting up, it's probably too, I believe the yellow, new yellow, is too strong of a spring, and the purple is actually what the old yellow used to be, which is meant to be between that 9 and 11. So that's what you want to do if you're having issues with some up top, the kind of the throttle kind of just stutters, or it kind of sounds like your blow valve is going off a little bit. The second problem was the blow valve itself. It was having a little bit of surge down low in the RPM range, and that was from the blow valve spring. They ship it to you with the yellow spring pre-installed, and then they give you it with the blue spring as an extra spring for higher boost. I'm Phase 1. I was having issues with the yellow. I went to Phase 2. I'm sorry, I went to the blue spring, and it held much, much better and took that issue away as well. So going back to the tune, I have the Phase 1 tune with burbles. I don't know if you just heard that and it might not pick up that great. The burbles tune I think sounds great. I have other videos you can check through my channel. I'll link them up here and everywhere. The burbles tune I think sounds great on this car. There's a pops and bangs, much louder, kind of like gunshots. It's very, very, very loud. It's more pronounced. You hear it more often. Where the burbles, it's just like once in a while. It's more, as I like to call it, a little bit of breaking up in the exhaust, a little bit of crackle here and there. Nothing too crazy. But once in a while, when you're getting on it, you'll hear that louder pop and bang. And I love it. It adds just enough character every so often that you hear it, but it's not obnoxious all the time. And some people like that. I had it on my old car. My Golf R had the pops and bangs. So I'm not talking bad about it. It's all personal preference at the end of the day. It's whatever you prefer. So the tune itself, strong, powerful, pulls smoothly after I fixed all the issues with the, you know, the Forge products. So there's a couple pops and bangs for you. If you heard it, you might not have, but the car just feels great. It feels smooth. It pulls throughout the RPM band from low to high. Like I said, this car doesn't produce a ton of low end or a ton of top end, and that's fine. In the future, I'll be going phase two, as well as eventually, most likely, the bigger turbo, which is really gonna help with the up top. But it just, it feels great, it sounds great, the tune 100% helped. And I do wanna make a point though, that the phase one tune, it's gonna feel different for different folks. And the reason is Eurocompulsion dials in their tune according to your mods. Phase one is good up until, well, basically it's good from completely stock up until, you know, whatever mods you want, they'll dial you in a phase one tune. With me, I have almost everything you need to go to phase two besides the intercooler. So with that being said, I'm right on the line of going to phase two, but I'm running a phase one where there could be another person running phase one completely stock. It's still phase one, but it's gonna feel completely different. My car or someone else who has the other mods are gonna feel a little bit more power than someone who's completely stock phase one. So that's something just to take into consideration. They have phase one completely stocked. They'll run a tune for you completely stock. You're gonna get an increase in power. It might not be what I'm feeling because I have the other supporting mods, which includes a full Ragazone exhaust system from their downpipe with a high flow cat, including their crosspipe, midpipe, and valved axle back. It's a full 70 millimeters, 2.75 inches. I have the EC Eurocompulsion V4 intake, the Forge blow valve, atmospheric, and the Forge wastegate actuator. All those combined with the phase one tune, so they dialed in my tune to those mods or the best that they could. And it's gonna have a little more power than on someone else who has a phase one with maybe, I don't know, just an axle back, which is not the biggest power adder when it comes to your exhaust. Anyway, right now I've been driving with the valves open. Now the good thing is, to me, it's not that droney. Even with the valves open, it's not super loud inside. It doesn't drone a ton. I'm coming from a Golf R, and then before that, I had an M3 that was, to me, really loud inside. But every other car, like, you know, it's just, it's not that loud. Hopefully the audio is even coming through proper. If you're watching this, then I guess the audio came through fine. If not, I'll have to re-record this entire video because I'm testing out some new audio equipment here with the microphones. So going back to everything we were talking about, it's basically the phase one tune. Is it worth it? Yes. Regardless of who you go with, do your research, pick whoever you want to go with. I went with Eurocompulsion. I've done my research. They've had outstanding service from what I've read, and now I can say they do because I've used them for my tune and some of my other products. So I went with them. You can, like I said, do your research, use whoever you want to, but I 100% recommend tuning the car. So yeah, 100% recommend tuning the car. Any factory turbo car, you're gonna see a really nice gain in power from a tune because they can safely raise the boost and just remap everything to get more power out of a car that's naturally aspirated. It's usually a little bit harder to get more power out of those, or a lot harder usually when it comes to being factory turbo and not factory turbo. So on a car like this, you're gonna see that power, you're gonna feel it, it's gonna be noticeable. Is it gonna be like an insane amount? Not really. In the sense of, like, I'm coming from a Golf R, I've had a few Evos, those are larger engines, they're 2-liter, 4-cylinder turbos, everything's bigger on them. Those things, a tune and your basic bolt-ons, you're looking at 80 to 100 horse. Where this, maybe you're looking at 40, 50, you know what I mean? So you might be getting in horsepower number-wise half the amount, but don't forget this car weighs so light. It weighs so much less than any of those other cars I just said. So with that in mind, you know, just understand the whole power to weight ratio. 40 horse on this is not 40 horse on a Golf R. It's gonna feel a lot more. because the car itself starts off with a lot less horsepower, so the percent increase is higher. And on top of that, the car itself just weighs so much less, so that power to weight ratio, you're actually getting more power to weight, you know, compared to a Golf R or an Evo or other cars like that. So in this car, even just a phase one tune, which is your most basic tune, mind you, I do have some bolt-ons that you know, support that tune a little bit more than the other guys who might be completely stock, it's 100% worth it. You feel it. It makes the car drive, it makes the car drive better, but it's just, it's such an engaging car. It feels great. I 100% recommend it. Like I said, when it comes to the tuning it and dialing everything in, I had some issues with the blow valve and the wastegate actuator. It was all spring related. I never got like a brand new tune from Eurocompulsion, which was like the last resort. Toby did say like he'll mess with the boost curve and whatnot until I don't get any issues. But luckily we were able to solve all the issues by swapping out the springs. It was just the spring pressures were off. Therefore, blow valve and wastegate actuator were kind of going off and they weren't working properly. It feels good, I'm telling you. It feels strong, it pulls, it's fun, it's engaging. Oh man, if you guys haven't driven one, now I'm just going off. Like, if you haven't driven a 124, it's an amazing car. Is it fast? Let me see. Is it quick? It's quick. Is it fast? I'm not gonna say it's fast. It's quick. It could become fast. It could become faster. It's extremely fun. It's definitely quick, especially for what it is. It's quick. It's no slouch. It's quick. You tune it, it's even quicker. Is it fast? Well, I guess it depends what cars you've driven. For me, no, it's not, you know, extremely fast, but it's quick and it's fun. It's engaging. It's got a ton of character. I personally love the looks of it. So with that being said, I'm probably going to end this video soon. You know, the Ragazone exhaust, I went with it because I, one, wanted a valved system. The Golf R kind of spoiled me. It had a valved system, and I liked the fact that I could close it when I want to be a little bit quieter. Although with this car, like I said, inside, honestly, it's not that loud, or at least it doesn't sound that loud. It doesn't drone inside. To my surprise, outside, it's pretty damn loud. I've heard some outside clips from me recording it, and it sounds pretty damn loud. But inside, this exhaust does a really good job of keeping the drone down and keeping the sound down and muffled, although it sounds really, really nice outside. Maybe I'll throw in a clip right here for you to hear, and I'll have the link to that as well if you want to hear the full clip. And since it's a full 70 millimeters, 2.75 inches, it should allow me to extract the most power from it as possible. I know a lot of the other exhaust systems are 2.5. Nothing wrong with that. I'm sure they're going to be totally fine. I also preferred the aggressive look of this exhaust. It's got huge 4-inch tips at the rear, which I'm not going to lie. When I first saw them, I was like, damn, those are big. But in time, I love them. You know, I fall in love with them. They look awesome. My Golf R had 4-inch tips, yet that's got a big rear end compared to this. That's a hatchback. But honestly, I love this exhaust in general. The look of it, the sound of it, the performance of it. So that's why I went with the Ragazone. So that's it. You know, hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. It kind of covered the current state of the car, how it feels, how it drives, the tune itself. Now I know it's getting a little dark out. I'm not sure if we could even see in the car, but I do have a racing shift knob, racing as you pronounce it, I believe. I love it. It's weighted. It feels great. It also has a red tone to it, which matches the red tack and the red stitching on the seats. I also have a Redline Goods shift boot, an e-brake boot, black Nappa leather with red stitching as well to kind of go with that whole red stitching. It really, you know, to me, I love doing these little things, you know, increasing the driving ability with the shift knob and just the overall look and aesthetics interior of the car. If you guys are interested in those, I will have a link in the description. I know Redline Goods has a 20% off coupon. It should still be active. I've been posting it for people, whoever wants it. So that's going to conclude it for this video. Hope you guys got some value out of this. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to like and comment. Let me know what you think about it. If you want to see some other videos, this car, other cars, other different, you know, content, Don't forget to subscribe as well. I'm going to keep producing more content to the best of my ability. And I do have the links to all the products I went over as far as the Shift Boot and some other products in the description. They are affiliate links, but they do help support the channel. So I would greatly appreciate if you guys are interested in those products, if you would use those links below. Thanks again. Have a great day, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.